Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Atlas. We get beat up by the giraffe behind us. So I ended up turning our little base, modified it a little bit, turned it into a taming pen. Oh yeah. Ooh, you gave me a good whack. So basically what I did was squared out the little platform we had. I think this is a 5x4. It's not too bad. It could be in a little better position, but I really didn't have too much building options as far as locations. I also put up a little base over here. We're going to go over there because we're starving. Just a really simple base. Nothing extravagant. We're going to tame that sucker in there. Also, I met the guys who own this island, and we are now allies, so they are always blue to us like that. It allows us to build a little bit closer to, which allowed me to set up a little base out here. I mean, just super simple, just a platform up on the rock. This is the garden I got going. Just a couple of each, nothing too spectacular. See if we can make it to the bed before we die. Just all the basic stuff that we had over there set up along the wall. Gonna wait until... And I've been doing some missions non-stop to build up enough money. And now I have the money to build a galleon. And we shall build the galleon. But I also wanted to get all of the stone building. Even though we need to go and get a rhino, I found an elephant in the water and two more bears. I'm telling you, just finding animals everywhere. And that'll give us all the stone building right there. Because I want to build the base in stone. It'll look a lot better. That dude's over there all mad. I'm not sure if I have any songs. Let's see, it's just treasure maps. Something else that happened, which I'm kicking myself in the butt for not recording, but just doing treasure maps, and I saw Brigantine out just sitting in the water. I was like, I'm gonna sail by this guy. And as I got closer, his brig sunk, just went straight down to the bottom. And, you know, me being the pirate that I am, decided, hey, let's go get all this stuff. So we got a good chunk of gold, and holy moly did we get a lot of blueprints from him. I mean, tons of blueprints. 211 six-run cannons, medium cannons. 211%. I also got, you know, a lot of planks and decks, and I ended up on one of my maps that I did that was really hard, we got this 210 mythical Hydra revolver, which, pretty interesting. Six types of oil. Yeah. Got a 176 small shipyard also, but we don't definitely don't have the materials for that. So I figure we will try to tame this giraffe over here, because he's blue and we like blue, and start building on the base a little bit more. Start getting it to how we want it. So with no further ado, let's get to taming. Check out my skills. See if I got sneak all the way up. Yep, I'm a sneaky bastard, let me tell ya. These giraffes are not easy to tame, even the low level ones. You gotta really build the cage right. I think I'm in the sweet spot. My cat thinks I'm in the sweet spot too. I'll be able to get one more feed. I'm gonna wait until it ticks down a little bit to feed them. Feed them as close to zero as possible, that way that time's ticking away while you're shooting arrows. To redesign the cage a little bit. Well, that wasn't good. Lucky, snuck in there, got it the first time. And then you shoot her in the butt. I got her fed. She's not being nice. Thank you. neck is in a spot where I can't feed her. Unless I just run up like that. So at this point I just start watching the time, and it's 20 seconds, so every 20 seconds you can run up and feed her again and pull back. Doing high level, you need songs, pretty much, and a buddy is nice. One more feed, baby, and you're mine. Too bad she wasn't a little higher level. Run over here and make her saddle real quick. There she is, my boat, the Power Stoner. A little beat up, but trucking right along. That's a whole lot of dead bodies over there. And I ended up going and picking up that crate that was floating in the water just south of our island, and there was 7,000 silver in it. So yeah, I think I need to adjust the cage a little bit and make it a bit... Well, I've seen some that they take out the walls on the bottom once you get the walls on the third section so that it doesn't spin around like that. I'm not sure how many you have to leave in there. But then at the same time, that really doesn't help when you're trying to tame bears either. But the dude seed on this island gave me a really good bear I've been using to do maps with. It was going to be too heavy with me on, but I guess not. When you put them on your hot bar like that, it stops the time on them. Just gonna unload all this stuff I have for taming that's on me. Oh, I'm out of salt. Which, we found a bunch on that brig. Where did I put that? I can almost make it, but I'm a midget. I put it I thought I stuck it in the only chest I use. This one's in case I want to drop all my equipment real quick and fast travel to another bed somewhere or another boat. Must be on my boat still. Oh yeah, here we go. This is just all the stuff I've been getting from doing missions. Found that in the brigantine. I think I found that in the brigantine also. I feel bad for the guy, but you know, what can I do but be a pirate and loot his stuff? I jumped on the scuba diving, put on the scuba diving suit and went down and oh yeah, I need to put salt over there. Now that I unlocked the stone building materials, I can start flushing out the base a little bit more. I Need to go get a rhino though. Rhinos eat turnips. I think it's either turnips or onions. Do I got turnips? Ooh, yeah, I did get turnips from one of the islands that I was doing missions on. So we'll build a couple large plots real quick and throw them down before it rains. So they can start getting water. Let's see, what do I need? Stone and wood. Thought I grabbed a stack. Guess not. Throw up two of each. I can't place on the water? Why not? What about underwater? Yeah, I don't have to set up any watering systems here because it rains so much, which is kind of nice. Just throw one right there. Take off, bird. Looks good because we're going to redo everything anyways. Ooh, I think I need poop. I got a poop machine over here on the deck. I need to get rid of some of this weight. It's so heavy. Probably all that stone I took. I'll just ditch everything in the resource box. Oh, it's all the wood. Okay. And I got my gear. I should throw that on the ship. I'm not using it at the moment. I don't like carrying a lot of stuff on me because if I die and body glitches through the earth or, you know, something good like that, then you lose your stuff. Trying to keep it to a bare minimum. Oh, and speak of the devil, it's raining. Grab a little bit of thatch. I was hoping for some big poop. Little poop will work. I have nothing against little poop. Because, you know, poop adds up. Then you can even jump on this guy and right click and make him poop. think he poops on his own every 30 seconds, and you can make him poop every 30 seconds or something like that. I wonder if his poop rolls downhill. What do you think? No? That's a monster piece of poop. It's not letting me do turnips. Wrong type of soil. Yep. It's not on the list. A6 is an ocean. I wonder if maybe I put one on the ground? I don't think so though. Cause there is no ocean in there anywhere. Just in the wrong biome. Gotta face effects. I don't want to. Oh, why'd I do that? Cause I'm an idiot. See if I can repair this. What am I missing? Metal? Where did all the metal go? I think I stuck it all in the... So I built some materials for the dock just to kind of get it fleshed out to where we want it, and I think we can replace them with stone, if I'm not mistaken. Should probably test that out. Yeah, it looks like you still. So I could do it in wood, just so I got like the basic form down good, and then just replace it with stone, and I'll get the stuff from the wood back. That'll work out decent, I think. Didn't want to raid that without making more. So, I paused the video for a second, and I started grinding on some planks. I've been going for about 2 hours now. So yeah, this is gonna be a bit of a grind. So, I was also thinking, I found that one. Large shipyard. Let's see what it was. +117. I mean, yeah, might as well just throw it down and place it in place where the other one's at. It is better. And I got it for free. That brigantine that sank, so we'll just go over here, and this was the only place I could find to launch this, or to put the large shipyard where it would allow me to actually launch a galleon and a brig. Just mosey on out here and see if I can drop this one in the exact same place, which might be a little tricky. I wish I could take that little island over there. I might have to ask the owners, because that would be really cool. Okay, let's try to do this. It has to be. It was hard dropping this the first time. Oh, that was it. I think it's right there. Oh, yeah. Let's go check out the positioning. Yeah, that'll give me plenty of room to drop. I might hit the galleon plank on the right side right there, but I think we'll be okay. And then I'm just gonna have to park my galleon out here. I'll probably build a little, little platform off the side of this. Yeah, I should be okay. Inventory's too heavy to. Oh, yeah, I got all that. Nice. Does that actually. Oh, what? It makes it more expensive. Oh no. I don't know. That brought my gold expense up. I might have to go do more maps. Oh. That sucks. Okay, well, now we know. Building a higher quality galleon is more expensive gold-wise. I was wondering why my friend told me that it was 86,000 to build a galleon, and then when I looked on mine, it was 50. So, that's the difference. So I need, like, 57. Great. Well, might have to go do more treasure maps. I need to do a bunch more grinding of materials. Because I need, like, 74 planks. I think it just took me, like, an hour and a half or so to get 20. So, yeah. Grinding alone. Fun times. And I got a couple common blueprints that were pretty decent. The 109 and 107, which this one was pretty good. The one almost 120, and it's just a common. And then I built a bunch of ceiling tiles, and I don't need those. Those are going to be for the base, but roof and ceiling tiles, and I need to build some walls, but not that many, so right now I think I need to go grind some more, so I'll pause it here for a second, and we'll be right back. Okay, I think we're going to jump on the boat real quick and go and do some maps, because we need about 5,000 more to make a galleon now that we put up that upgraded shipyard. Unfortunately. So. Maybe we can pick up a rhino while we're out. Yeah, that might be a. Because we're going to need a... We don't need one, but it'll make it a lot easier if we had a rhino. We start building stone. Which I would like to start doing here soon. Wouldn't mind building a little tiny house at the top of that big rock right there. Or maybe something across between the two. And the house up there. Something like that. Get turned around here and we'll head on out. We're gonna check the bank before we leave the system or the sector. I got about half the planks for the galleon made. So, make the other half when we get back. If I can get into the jet stream here, we got a map in A8. I'm going to start there. Thank you. A8, then I'll probably hop over to C6. And then I think I need to go south. I got a lot of maps down in the A, B, C, D, 10, 11 area. K11. And then I could break through the wall and get these two. A and E1. Hopefully this will be a quick trip. I only need about 7K just to have like a 1,000 extra or so. As soon as I hit that, I'll come back. I'm thinking there might be rhinos in C6. Hopefully, but we will see when we get there. This bear makes pretty short work of these. Just another wonderful Atlas glitch. Thank you. Just let Daisy hang out there. She likes the breeze in her face. Now we're just gonna hit that Gulf Stream and head south to A8. Or Jet Stream, whatever they call it. That was a quick 1,000 though. Not too bad. This is how people get their boat sunk. Or, you know, shoot right by their destination, like I just did. That's fine, we'll just get aligned here. Get her dialed in to the stream. We'll be on our way. Now that we're dialed in, we need to actually locate where the map is. Which island? This wreck is. We're looking for, I think it's higher than a 16 or something like that. Which I've never seen, I hardly ever see anything above 10. 4.3. And that is for the, what do they call it? Raider of the Deep. Because I want to be a raider and a pirate. Yeah, I was hoping we didn't disconnect coming across the border. It seems to happen a lot. You really haul butt in these jet streams. I want to, or I can't wait to see how the galleon is in these. I think I'm gonna just do 6 large speed sails on it. I'm going to use the old design, the arc design. I really like that one. It's simple, easy to move a large amount of animals around and get them on and off your boat without too much hassle. then we have these guys always sitting in the middle of the jet stream. I've seen a lot of damaged ones. See, he's damaged a little bit. And he's a horrible shot. I wonder if they take damage from being in here. Because, I mean, I've seen some that were almost destroyed. Good old Ozzy the ostrich. His chucking up there makes you know that you're still connected to the game. What's the wind doing? Besides being all crazy. I'm not gonna stop at every bank. That one was kind of close, though. I could have stopped there pretty easily. So we'll get on down to our destination. Let's see. It's 7:22 for this one. Yeah. Well. Some of these are only like 500-600 gold. Probably should keep hitting up banks as much as possible. We can hit up this one right here. Maybe hit this one on the way out if we don't get anything from the first one. It seems like one of them gets gold and the other one doesn't. So maybe it's like one fills up and then the other one starts, or I don't know, because there's a lot of times I've been to both of the banks and the sector and one of them will have gold and the other one won't. So if anybody knows that for sure, leave a comment, let me know. I think we'll turn right here and head for that first bank. the excitement and anticipation. Feel it build. We'll hit the other one up before we leave the system. Sector system. Keep saying system. Like we're playing a space game. Get dialed in here. I'll pause it so you don't have to see me sail. Okay, we are pulling up to the island. I'm gonna whip around to the other side, I think. Nice little island, though. Good elephant, like a higher level. Ooh, that looks like a nice little house back there he made. Oh, he has a blue giraffe. I like blue giraffes. Did you can tame crocodiles? I did not know that. Some nice looking elephants over there. Oh wow, there's 7 people in this system. Okay, let's figure out where this map is. Straight in front of us. Got my shovel. I think we're ready to roll. It's a 23. Change of plans. Let's see if we can do this from the back of a bear. does a little too much damage, though. So two bites will kill this ostrich. So I have to, like, bite him and then let him heal up, or maybe try to arrow him. Maybe I jump off and just hit him with my axe. Something like that. It's good there's not any hostile animals around. As long as I don't hit anybody, they shouldn't aggro me. Feeding time, like 15 seconds on these things. At least we didn't kill the one we're trying to tame. Kind of surprised that we didn't kill him. Man, we need to do a little searching around, maybe. Level 30 ostrich would be nice. So yeah, I will just whack him down with my axe. I think that'll work good.
Oh.
Their feeding zone seems to be really easy to get into. I mean, normally they do peck a lot, but might just be because I have sneak 3. Because I'm a sneaky old bastard. Yeah, I have a friend. He used to tame everything from the back of a bear. I mean, he would do level 30 elephants and giraffes, no problem. Set the bear to passive. I'm surprised he didn't rip this thing apart for pecking him. Go away, elephant. I think my old ostrich was like a level 4. So this will be a significant upgrade. Probably should have secured the area a little better before I start taming. Right back on track though. Everybody dies now. chilies. Well, this dude made a stairway to heaven. Okay, I was about to freak out and say, where's my shovel? Gotta keep an eye on that turtle over there. It's looking like he's gonna try something. What, is everything a level 3? No, there's level 10. And there's just a lot of stuff on this island. Oh, you know what I just thought of? You can see the elephants and stuff like this. And a little bit more pain in the butt as you roll right up on them. So we'll just head out to the next map here. C6 right on that little island right there. Right there is where we need to go. I'm gonna stop off. Just cruise by these islands, see if there's rhinos on the way there. Hopefully there's just rhinos on the island in C6. That'd be nice. Yeah, there was 7 people in this system when we came in. I'm not going to check the banks. More than likely, someone's already checked them. We are up to almost 2K. Just got to keep working on that gold. See him from shore pretty easily. Looks like elephants and giraffes. Not seeing any rhinos here. Move along to the next island. Gotta love how fast the schooner with the large speed sail goes. Just cruises right along. Can't wait to get the galleon, it's even faster. Ooh, let's see what this wreckage is. We need a 16 or higher still, which I think they're pretty rare. Too bad they won't let you use the little telescope to see what number it is. See if there's some rhinos on this island. Definitely on the hunt for a rhino. I think we could fit one on the boat. It'll be tight. Ooh, we can't get the Discovery here, though. Well, and away we go. I think that's our island right there. And I think we hit up this bank just for the fun of it. Plot our next course. I think we're gonna go to E1 next, then head over to A1. So probably just head up straight to this, hit that to E1, hop over to this, hit that to A1. Disappointment. looks like a good map. Let's go find out. I usually tell by the color they shine. Yeah, it's a fine D9. This looks like a common. Okay, let's get on over to our treasure map. Pretty sure we're gonna go on top of this big rock. Not sure if this is one that's in the rock or server lag, maybe. Okay, I'm thinking it's in the rock because it's only letting me. It's giving me rock when I dig. Well, it's raining, I'm cold, I'm starving, time to jump off a cliff. Luckily, Daisy has enough health to take it. Put the old shovel away. We're going to bring this episode to an end. I'd like to thank everybody for joining me today. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, and I will see you in the next episode.